Now, Deacon John has done extensive research into this particular theory,
mm-hmm.
and he's going to bring some pretty important information to the table to show you how the government has laid out these laws, including false flags, which have caused lives, not just here in America, but around the world, to create these laws and this infrastructure to be able to circumvent the mob threat, or what they call the mob threat, during that time when this general population thinks that their lives are in danger and they won't overrun these prepared locations. Deacon John is here with us now.
Deacon.
Yes, I'm here. Thanks, Adam. Thanks, Kosick. Obviously Kosick was given an overview of the astrological or astronomical and the historical evidence. So, we look at three streams of evidence, one being the scientific, the astronomical, and that's sort of Terrell's expertise, and the assumption being that a lot of the bizarre weather changes you've seen recently and a lot of the behavior of our governments is not due to just any random acts. It's due to the fact that there may be a heavy mass object coming into our system, mm-hmm. which will affect the Earth's the Earth as far as its geophysical and stuff, and that you've seen an increased volcanism, a lot of earthquakes, that type of thing. So that's one stream of evidence. The second stream of evidence Kosick alluded to is the historical. We feel that a lot of ancient societies have left evidence in their literature, mythology, and religion pointing to that type of cataclysmic event which has happened in the past. And what I've been focusing on is the human or geopolitical evidence, what our government's done, the laws they've passed, the preparation that they've put in place over the last decade or so to get ready for this type of event. One of the assumptions we are making is that 9/11 was an inside job, chiefly to be able to put a police and control grid into place and pass laws to make Americans give up their liberty and economic freedoms where normally they would not do something like that. So we feel that the government used that, created a terrorist event to justify a lot of the laws and changes they've made. So what we're looking at is the global warming myth propagated by the government and Al Gore versus what we call abrupt climate change scenario based on the possibility of the astronomical event with the heavy incoming mass object. And one of the things I've been looking at is the behavior of our federal government, the laws they've passed, some of the federal agencies, for example. I'll just throw some facts out for your audience. In February of 2011, FEMA, and that is the agency, Federal Emergency Management Agency, tasked with cleaning up and helping the population after natural disasters, bought $1 billion in freeze-dried food. It's because of so-called terror threats. Everyone in your audience is probably familiar about the camps and coffins and underwater bags and that type of thing that's been floating around on YouTube.
Right.
Also, in May of 2011, FEMA and NASA being the National Space Administration, National Aeronautic and Space Administration, did a joint readiness exercise with FEMA entitled Eagle Horizon, which I thought was very interesting. The question I asked was, why is FEMA, the agency tasked with natural disasters and helping the population, why did they do a joint readiness exercise with the Space Administration? Awfully strange. And, of course, we had the FCC test on November 9th of 2011 of the Nationwide Emergency Warning System. And so those are some of the things, the behavior of the government. Also, I think your audience is probably aware of the concept of martial law. The Constitution itself gives Congress and the President the power to declare martial law. Real quickly, Article 1, Section 8 gives Congress the power to provide for calling forth the militia to execute the laws of the Union, suppress insurrections, and repel invasions. And also Article 2, which deals with the powers of the presidency, gives the president the power to create executive orders because it's tied into his power or responsibility to take care that the laws be faithfully executed. And so if you take a look at, I don't want to go too much into detail here, just with the overview, but if you go to my webpage, which is www.deaconjohn614.com, that's deaconjohn614.com, I've got a page devoted to the relevant executive orders dealing with beefing up the martial law framework that the government's created. And so I've come up, and Kosick and I have come up with a four-phase timeline based on the geopolitical events. The first phase would be normal commerce, life, and society. All would appear normal. And the powers that be have used this period to prepare. And Kosick alluded to the underground bunkers, the FEMA, the military planning, that type of thing I think your audience is probably familiar with.
Right.
And we can trace this back to approximately 1979-1980. Our research has uncovered the fact that scientists and mathematicians felt since 1965 that there was some kind of 12th planet or heavy mass object that was affecting our system.
Going back thousands of years, the term planets included a variety of different objects, from the sun and the moon to satellites and asteroids. A clear definition for what a planet is was established in the year 2005 with the discovery of the trans-Neptunian object named Eris. However, under a new definition proposed by the International Astronomical Union, 9 planets would become 12. This definition, which applies only to the solar system, states that a planet is a body that orbits the sun, is massive enough for its own gravity to make it round, and has cleared its neighborhood of smaller objects around its orbit. So in short, there are at least 12 heavenly objects within our solar system that has been discovered.
And they really didn't have any kind of visual proof, just mathematical equations and that type of thing. Well, in 79, NASA launched Voyager.
Right.
And Voyager traveled outside of our space system, and we believe that Voyager gave them the photographic evidence they needed to confirm their mathematical calculations. And ever since then, actually, starting when Ronald Reagan was president, with continuity of government in Rex 84, you see a series of executive orders in the presidency and the military acting to get ready for not only nuclear war, but natural disasters. So that's phase one, and we feel that probably ended about mid-2005, perhaps as late as 2008. For example, the CIA has been moved from its headquarters in Langley, Virginia, to Denver, Colorado,
right.
Which I thought is awfully strange. And the rumor is that the government has constructed an underground city out underneath the Denver airport, and that'll be, in the case of an extinction-level event, that'll be where the government goes underground. I think we're in phase, at the end of phase two right now. We have increasing earth changes, increasing volcanism, we have earthquakes. I mean, I live in Ohio, Columbus, Ohio here, and it was 50 degrees today, and it's been raining for 3 days, which is really isn't all that normal for December in my neck of the woods. And so, you know, the powers that be have been promoting this global warming over the past decade, that all the bizarre weather changes is due to anthropomorphic global warming, meaning that we're causing it because we're over-utilizing the Earth's natural resources, and we just need to get green and cut down and conserve and that type of thing. And so they're sort of promoting that myth. But, of course, you see increasing Earth changes in the news every day. Now it's become common fare, that type of thing.
Mm-hmm.
And we feel that one of the ways that the government is going, they put a police grid in place after 9/11. You've got DHS, Transportation Safety Administration, for example, I mean, if you over the holidays or Christmas or Thanksgiving or New Year's, if you want to go visit your loved ones who live in a different part of the country, you've got to go through a naked body scanner, right? And if you don't want to go through a naked body scanner, they want to stick their hands down your pants, right? I mean, come on, seriously, because some 19-year-old kid tried to light his underwear on fire a couple years ago on an airplane. Yeah. This stuff just doesn't make sense, and we think that it's part of the control grid, right? And they've also got the 72 fusion centers, which Department of Homeland Security, CIA, FBI has gotten together and coordinated with your local state and local law enforcement officials, and what they are is they're spy centers. There's 72 of them. They're called threat fusion centers. We have one here in Columbus, Ohio, and that and the Patriot Act, we feel they've been using to spy on the American people. So in any event, at the end of phase two, Kosick and I feel that they're going to pop a what's called a false flag event, a possible terrorist attack or dirty bomb or nuclear attack or perhaps martial law, economic martial law, because if they do something like that, then the population will ask for martial law. They'll say, you need to protect me. We've got a lot at stake here. I don't have a problem with martial law.
Right.
And normally folks would not accept someone sticking their hand down their pants, right, when you want to get on an airplane.
Right.
So they were saying is they have to come up with some kind of excuse to put their grid in place. And so we feel that that'll occur before phase three, which is in a relatively short period of time, perhaps several days or a week, people will realize that things are dangerous, things aren't quite right as far as the environment's concerned, and they'll start to act strangely. So they want to get that lockdown grid in place before that happens. And, of course, phase four would be, of course, if we have the astronomical event, of course, normal human activity would cease. Homes for millions of people would be destroyed. There'd be major economic and social collapse and that type of thing. So those are some of the things we've been working on. Real briefly, I just want to end up my overview here is one of the things that Kosick came up with, which I thought was quite brilliant. I don't know if you're familiar with the Hegelian principle. George Hegel was a German philosopher in the 1800s. And he wrote a series of works, one of which was trying to explain, it was called Phenomenology of Spirit, how to explain history and human culture and interaction with what he called Geist or Spirit, God. And his formula was thesis, antithesis, synthesis, or simply put, problem, reaction, solution. And so over the past decade or so, we've seen the problem being terrorism, 9/11, global warming, the wars in Iran and Afghanistan, the economic crisis, WikiLeaks Anonymous, and most recently Occupy Wall Street and civil disobedience. And so especially we've been focusing on Occupy Wall Street and civil disobedience. We feel this is probably the best candidate at the time for the government to use as a false flag to prepare the population for martial law. And so if we've got the problem created by the government, then we would have a reaction, right? The reaction, Patriot Act, DHS, TSA, the Green Movement, TARP, the National Deficit, Patriot Act, and martial law. And again, we think it's crucial that the government create fear in the population so that they will ask for lockdown, they will ask for martial law.